Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Fixer Upper. Today we have a guest. She won't get off my lap, so I'll just record, you know, see what happens, right? She does not look happy to be here. I swear, she came here herself. But today we're gonna try and renovate a house built by one of you. And this house, this somewhat scary looking house, was built by Nicolina Hi-Hi on the gallery. It's called Abandoned House, and the description says, a house with lots of potential that's now abandoned because the previous owners disappeared. And then they say, do not look in the attic. So naturally, first things first, the attic. Even my cat got scared away by this. There's four coffins in the attic, just up there. Two of them are tiny, so that's a little bit concerning. Do you know what? With these fixer-uppers, no one ever just, moves. There's always some horrible tragedy. They had to die, there was a tornado that swept them away, they fell into a pit at the bottom of the house. They never just, up and move to Florida. They're always, in the attic or in the basement. You know, it appears that that is one thing that all of us have in common, is we love to ruin our Sims' lives, even the fake Sims, for fake tragic backstories. But if you didn't know, I have this series on my channel called Fixer Upper, where I renovate houses that you guys build. Usually scary houses like this one. Abandoned, old, run-down, cobweb-filled houses. And this one has given us a budget of 15,000 simoleons to renovate. So I've got us set up here, we've got the house. Let's do a quick tour, shall we? In classic fixer-upper fashion, there are scratches and cracks in all the doors and windows. Broken car. Somehow, this tree has grown up and then died in a tire. Graffiti, fallen down trees, the backyard's got an old well. A perfectly in good condition grill, though, I might keep that. But just in general, you know, it's overgrown, the windows are broken, it could use a fresh cone of paint. You get the idea. And then inside, it's a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom house. So when you first walk in, you've got this really nice small kitchen area. Could probably use some fresh appliances. As you can see, I don't think this one is doing okay. And then there's a little office off the kitchen. When you walk through the hallway, it takes you into the dining and living area combo. Also a little bit messy. I like this floral chair and I think I might keep it. Perhaps we could refinish the fireplace, I don't know. Also, something I did not know until very recently is that these spider webs actually generate spiders that move on them. For some reason, I was under the impression that those spider webs were just decorative. I did not know that if you ran the game, there would be spiders on them, but there are. So that ruined my day. I only ever use those in build mode to make stuff like this. I don't usually play in it afterwards. So for some reason, I hadn't noticed that. It's been years. Those came with a vampire's pack, but perhaps I was lucky to go this long without knowing. There's actually a really nice bathroom. It has a golden shower and everything, but it looks really good. And then there's one bedroom downstairs, one kid's bedroom, also covered in posters and spider webs and such. Don't look too closely because there might be spiders. And then upstairs, there's a tiny hallway with whatever that is. More spiders. And then two more bedrooms, one for the parents, one for a toddler. And then for some reason, this lucky toddler has its own ensuite bathroom. They have the second bathroom in the house. And that is the whole place. I feel like I really love the shape of this house. I love the windows. I love this little bee window at the top. I think it has a lot of potential. As far as things I might want to change, I mean, obviously, cleaning it up is number one, but I might swap some of the floor plan a little bit. I was thinking about possibly switching the kitchen and this area and make this into the kitchen so you don't just walk straight into the kitchen, and perhaps putting the bathroom here. And I might swap it so that the toddler has the room downstairs instead of upstairs, because toddlers do not really frequent the stairs. Because in my opinion, toddlers are not so good with stairs, and sometimes they can't even go up them if they're not high enough movement skill, and other times they're just slow. So I think I'm gonna put the toddler downstairs just for ease of gameplay. But otherwise, that is my plan. Oh, I also intend to leave the previous owners. I feel like it would be wrong to remove them. It is their house after all, so I'm gonna keep these coffins up here. But with that being said, let's go ahead and jump right on into the renovation. Actually, first, I wanted to tell you all that my pink sensitive hoodies are back in stock. You know these beautiful, amazing, wonderful hoodies that you all love so much. Look at how adorable. Back in stock. LittleSimsyShop.com. We have a few things. We also have a whole Boo collection right now for Halloween, so I'm just saying, if you want to grab something, LittleSimsyShop.com. Okay, now we're renovating the house. So first things first, as is always in these fixer-uppers, we go through and we delete everything. The goal is to go in and clean up the house, you know, remove the old landscaping, take out the cracks in the windows, if only it were that easy to just click and delete on a crack. So I went in, deleted all the bad stuff, the spiders, the stains, you know, and then we could actually start renovating. I love that part. I love going through and deleting everything. I feel like it's very satisfying to do and to watch. watch. But I just wanted to tell you all, if you want to build a house for Fixer Upper, hashtag fix me Lil Simsy on the galleries where you post them. Anything goes, pretty much any sort of style of house. I mean, obviously it should be a little bit run down. And I like it when they have somewhat of a backstory, and when you give me a budget and maybe like a story for the new owners, like, hey, the new owners have 4 kids and 10,000 simoleons. Like, I like that kind of thing, because then I have an idea of how to renovate it. It's also always funny when, you know, you leave the owners in the attic. But maybe not funny for them, but funny for us. Anyway, that's the idea. So first things first in the house, I think I mentioned this, but I ended up swapping the floor plan a tiny bit. I switched the kitchen and the bathroom's locations, and I actually removed the office study art space that was downstairs. I know it's probably not the best thing, but I felt like it was good to have a bigger kitchen. And also in real life, switching the plumbing, like that's easy, right? Easier than moving the kitchen to somewhere completely different, at least, is if you put the kitchen and the bathroom in opposite places, at least there's already plumbing there, you know? So this is a realistic renovation, all right? I also painted the whole house and I changed the window colors. I wanted to keep the windows in the same place because sometimes I come in and do these fixer-uppers and I just change everything completely. Other times I'm like, ooh, let's just refinish the floors and like paint the windows. And I was trying to be a little bit more realistic with this one. So I just kept the windows in the same places and then changed the colors of them. Although I did move a door and a window, I swapped them because I wanted the door to be in a slightly different place. And then we like refinished the original columns outside, like kept all this original charm. To be fair, this house is not actually the most like modern of updates. I feel like oftentimes in real life, when people get a house like this, they renovated a lot in the inside to be like really updated. You know? And in this one, I feel like I didn't do that. Like, I kind of kept a more closed off floor plan. I kept some kind of bad appliances. Like, in real life, I think you wouldn't have done that, but you know, maybe you would. Maybe you love the charm of an old fridge. Maybe you really like a fridge that objectively does not work as well as a new one, you know? Less energy efficient, breaks more often. I mean, there's just a little bit of charm in that, right? Right? Oh, but it looks good. The kitchen is probably not my best work, to be honest. The layout is not so ideal. I feel like it's realistic, but it's also not, again, ideal. But I was okay with that, because this house is old and it's small, so I kind of liked that about it. So I kept it. It's just the like, the whole idea of getting this brand new kitchen and then putting the fridge in like a bad spot is maybe not so realistic, but again, it was fun, so I don't care. Also, you might notice, you have to look closely for this, but Agnes Crumplebottom's purse by the front door. I don't know, I assume that was always there, but for some reason I didn't notice it until it was like the only thing left on the floor. And then I was like, wait a minute. How did that get there? So I ended up keeping it and putting it upstairs in the parents' bedroom. So these people stole Agnes's purse for some reason and then kept it. Maybe, oh my God, what if the original owners stole Agnes Crumplebottom's purse and then she got them for it? How do you think they got in the attic? They stole Agnes's purse? Oh, everything makes sense. She's immortal as well. So like, she's been around for ages. She could have done this like 50 years ago and you would never even know. Oh wow, suddenly everything is starting to make sense. It was Mrs. Crumplebottom. She did it. Anyway, so I built this on stream yesterday and it was a lot of fun. It always is. And the person who built the original is actually in chat. So it's kind of fun getting to hear from like the original builder when they're like right there talking to you about it and stuff. But also after I finished it, we spent like an hour and a half just like gossiping about The Sims. And I mean that in like a nice way because we spent like the rest of the stream after I finished the build, just like, I guess, speculating about things and like talking about past stuff that like were hints. And because we're talking about how I don't think The Sims does like hints for future packs so much as maybe they put Easter eggs. Because I feel like I'm talking in particular about two things. Number one, so back years ago in the olden times, Dine Out, when it came out, it had like two chef stove sets that you could use for your restaurants. And one of them has a baby bottle on the counter and the other one has a little teddy bear like hanging from the top of it. And everyone like assumed it was a hint for toddlers back in the day. And then that was like June 2016. And then in January 2017, toddlers came out in that update. So like, maybe it was a hint or like a little Easter egg for toddlers. I feel like the bottle on the counter is really weird and like maybe is a little hint. But we were kind of talking about how like, those things aren't necessarily really hints so much as they're like, again, Easter eggs. So I feel like a hint sort of implies that you'll figure it out. Like for example, in Snowy Escape, I actually used the plates in this build, but those little stacked up plates from Snowy Escape, they're called paranormal plates. And then right after Snowy Escape, we got the paranormal stuff pack. Now, I wouldn't call that a hint because, like, how would you look at that and assume, oh, we must be getting a paranormal pack just from, like, the name of plates? But when you look back on it, you're like, oh, were they teasing us? I don't know. Maybe someone on the team was like, haha, let's call it paranormal plates because we're gonna have a paranormal pack soon. Haha, then they'll laugh about it. Maybe, but, like, that's not really a hint so much as it is just a little joke, right? So we were kind of just discussing all these things for, like, an hour and a half. I had so much fun. I love just, like, talking about The Sims. I say as a person who has an entire Sims-based YouTube channel, this may shock you. But I love to talk about The Sims. But it's just fun to, like, sit and chat about, like, Sims things with a bunch of people. I don't know. I really enjoyed it. A couple things you may find interesting that I learned about during this chat. Number one, recently there has been 2 swords added to the base game debug. And they're different because I thought, I was like, oh, there's swords in the base game debug. Are they the swords from Get Famous? Like the ones from when they do the pirate fighting stuff in the acting career? They're not. They're different. So for some reason, I have no idea why, there are swords in the base game debug now. That could be absolutely nothing. Or it could be that they're making something. I don't know what would involve swords, but there's swords in the base game debug. And also, interesting thing to note is that the guts of sectional sofas, I mean, like, the meshes and, like, the functionality of sectional sofas is base game. So sectional sofas themselves right now are only in Dream Home Decorator, but the guts of sectional sofas are base game. So what that means to me is that possibly in the future, they intend on adding more sectional sofas in, like, a different pack, maybe not into the base game, but, like, you know how with bikes, we first got bikes in university and then we got more bikes in Eco Lifestyle and then, like, another bike with the pre-order bonus from Cottage Living. Bikes, like, the guts of bikes are base game. There isn't, like, any bikes in the base game, but they can use bikes in more than one pack. I feel like this means that we might get more sectionals in the future, which I really hope we will, because I love sectional sofas in The Sims, and I want more of them so bad, and I feel like this is a good, indicator that they might intend on doing it more in the future, right? I don't want to, like, assume, because it's a real stretch to, like, take this, things in debug and thing, like, the guts of things is not a good indicator or hint, I feel like, of anything, but I do like to assume that maybe in the future we'll get more sectionals because I really want some. I don't know how far in the future, it could be like a year from now, but it's possible. Which is all I want to know. That's what I need to hear. Oh my gosh, and also, I won't make a whole video on this because it was like such a small update, I feel like it would be hard to make a whole video about it, but The Sims teased 2 more kits yesterday. Oh. Which is a whole other thing. But they talked about in that roadmap a couple weeks ago that there's gonna be 4 kits in the next couple months and no other packs, which is not good. I feel like that's a bad sign for any possible expansion pack this year. I'm not, usually in the past, if there was gonna be another expansion this year, we would have heard about it by now. So I kind of have low expectations for another expansion pack this year, which is very sad. But they did talk about 4 more kits. We already got 2 of them, the fashions kits that we just got last week. And then they teased yesterday 2 more. Actually, I'll show you. This is an article from Sims Community called The Sims 4 Threatens with Another Kit, which made me laugh a lot, I'm not gonna lie. So the roadmap previously, try on looks that defy border, my face is covering it. Try on looks that defy borders and boundaries with 3 global fit kits, and then cultivate your modern sanctuary with a fresh new build kit. So we got 2 fit kits already, and it looks like from this, we're gonna get another one, defying style boundaries, and then the sanctuary vibes kit. So now that they've teased these a little bit more, I assume that means they're coming a little bit sooner? I don't know. I'm not sure about this. The sanctuary vibes thing intrigues me. I'm not super interested in clothing kits at all, so, like, that doesn't really interest me that much. But it is cool to see them talking about it, because, like, it's always fun to see more content, even if you don't want to buy it. Anyway, sorry for the detour. But it just, it made me laugh that he called it The Sims 4 Threatens Another Kit. So I thought I would share it with you all. I think we all relate to that. Listen, the title, it speaks to me, so I thought you'd like it too. But the house is kind of coming along here. You can see we finished most of the downstairs, and then we have, like, a couple bedrooms upstairs to work on. So I did end up keeping the bathroom in that tiny space that it was originally. I thought about trying to move it or, like, maybe putting it in the new dormer that I added upstairs, but I decided that it made the most sense where it was because, like, otherwise that space would be lost, and I didn't really want to lose that space because it, like, what would you put there instead? Maybe a closet, I guess? I don't know. But I decided to keep it because, like, realistically, you wouldn't get rid of a bathroom, you know? Like, why would you rip out plumbing in a perfectly good brand new bathroom just to make a closet out of it? Like, I don't know. So I kept it, even though it's weird that, like, the child has the only ensuite in the house. Whatever, at least it's upstairs, you know? So I made the kid's bedroom up here, and I tried to use that cottage living wallpaper. I actually used a lot of cottage living in this house, like the counters, the floors, a lot of the wallpapers, the parents' bed, the furniture in the living room is all cottage living, like even the dining chairs and stuff. So I did use that pack a lot in this one, but it just felt appropriate to me. Like, this house was kind of cottagey, so I wanted to use cottage living for it a bunch. I feel like it worked out. Like, the wallpaper kind of fits, you know, like everything just, it looked good. I'm a little bit biased, but I thought it looked good. And also, in case you ask, so you might have seen out in the front yard how the porch in the front and the back is, like, raised. It's almost floating, and it looks different than the rest of the foundation. That's not, like, a special trick or anything. That's just a different foundation type. Someone asked in my Twitch chat, so I thought I would tell you all, too. There's a couple stilted foundations that are base game now. They added those back around Island Living Time to the base game, and that's just one of them. So I put, like, the stilted foundation over the patio because, one, the original build had it, but two, a lot of times in real life, the porch will be like that, so I kept it. I used it too. I thought it looked nice. Most of the time, I don't bother with that, but it actually looks really good in this house, so maybe I'm feeling inspired. Maybe I'll start doing it more often. That's one of the fun things about Fixer Upper, is that I get to really see your builds and your ideas in, like, very up-close detail when I'm renovating them, because you see a picture of a house, and you're like, oh, that's nice, but you kind of, like, don't stop to notice all the little things. Like the window placement and, like, the foundation types I kind of ignore, and you just look at the big picture. But when you're actually renovating it, you have so much more time to look at all the details and be like, oh, that item as kitchen clutter is great. And then you can kind of use it too, which I guess is sort of what you guys do with, like, watching speed builds on YouTube to an extent, right? But to me, I just download your Fixer Upper builds and delete everything in them. That's how I get inspiration, is by deleting all your items. See? Oh, hang on, one more thing. I just want to apologize now for the number of times that I said guts in this video when I was talking about the guts of the sectional sofas. I think it's funny to call them that. I mean, like, the the, like, inner workings of sectionals and, like, the meshes of them and stuff. But when you call them guts, in my opinion, it just, it's funnier. So I did it on purpose, but I said it a lot of times in my Twitch stream yesterday. People kept complaining about it, so I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what I did, and I'm sorry I brought it up again. I'll just stop talking about it. I need to, Kayla, you can't keep talking about guts on YouTube. Stop it. The bill is almost done now, so I'm just putting on some, like, finishing touches, doing the landscaping. We got some gnomes in the front yard. I put a bike, like, leaning up against the stairs. I think it's so cute to use bikes as, like, decorations and builds. I don't know why. I think they're adorable. So I put them in my builds a lot. Like, in my legacy house on Twitch right now, I have that cottage living early purchase, early bird gets the worm bike leaning up against my fence. It's a real shame because that bike is so cute, but I do not like the concept of giving extra content to people who buy a pack early. That truly bothers me a lot, but, like, the bike is so cute. And there's that cute little gnome. I really hope they don't do that again. Just put the items in the pack. Like, why does it have to be a secret treat? I don't get it. It makes no sense to me, but whatever. There's no point complaining about it now. It's old news these days, but hopefully in the future it doesn't happen again. But the house is almost done here, so I'm gonna take you into game and show you, like, a tour of the finished product, because I know it's been a lot, and I've been talking about guts for a lot of this video, so you might have missed something. Quick reminder, this is the original build, so it's looking a lot different. I mean, the shape is there. The guts are there. It's just been cleaned up a little bit, you know? My finished product is called Abandoned House Reno on the gallery, and it looks like this. I think it's so cute. I'm sorry it's raining in my game. It's so annoying. It's been restored to its former glory, as you can see. I love the backyard too. I love 20 by 15 lots. I love how small they are. I love the tiny yards. I just think it's so cute. But we have some monkey bars. We have a little table. I kept that same grill, like I said I would, from the original. There's a couple plant pots around too, on both the patios actually. And a rocking chair, of course. This is the mailbox. It's, like, on the front door. Well, there's literally one on the front door actually, but then there's a real functional one next to the front door. And then when you first walk inside, remember, this room used to be the kitchen, this area, but I cut it in half and I put the bathroom on the right side where the kitchen used to be, and I made like a formal entryway. And then you walk through it into the living and dining room space. I kept those chairs I wanted to keep and the fireplace. So most of the house is kind of in the same spot, except the kitchen bathroom are switched. This is the new kitchen. We've got like some dog bowls. I love how this looks, the shelving looks. We got those paranormal plates. And I like the color scheme in here too, with the like wallpaper and the counter combo. I thought it looked nice. Downstairs, we have one bedroom. It's a toddler's bedroom. It's not very fancy. I wanted to keep it simple so you could update it if you needed to. We also didn't have that much money left over, so I wasn't trying to waste a lot. And then upstairs, stairs are in the same spot they always were as well. And then we have a slightly bigger hallway now because I added on this like 2x2 square to make another dormer. But there's like a little desk in there. I figured because we got rid of the original room office space, I would make a new one, but it is, as per usual, in the hallway. This is the parents' room. I love the color scheme in here. I think it looks so nice. And I used that bonsai tree. And then this is that kid's bedroom I was talking about. Also like the color scheme in here. That's a university bed. I never used that color on it. I also kept the Grim Reaper plushie because of course I did. And then that bathroom is the same it always was. I just got some new fixtures in it. This room is functional, by the way. This shower, your Sims will walk over it. You can make a one tile bathroom if you wanted to and they'll still use it. This shower is pretty useful. It's from university, but that's the whole house. And the family? Still there, don't worry. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I know my speed builds are like all over the place, I'm so sorry, but I hope you liked it anyway. And with that being said, I'll catch you all tomorrow. Bye everybody. And also, if you wanna make a house or fixer upper, it's #fixmeLilSimsy on the gallery. I wanna see your builds, please show me. They're so much fun.